So we continue Exodus 23 from verse 1-4. If you come upon your enemy ox and donkey that has strayed away, take it back to its owner. If you see that the donkey of someone who hates you has collapsed under its load, do not walk by. Instead, stop and help. In a lawsuit, you must not deny justice to the poor. May the Lord help us in Jesus' name. Yet the Lord said, as a born-again Christian, when you see any of your neighbor's property going astray, he said you should help him or her to protect it. And secondly, you should not deny a lawsuit over a poor person. When a poor person is involved in problem, and you are in position to help this person, to get all that he or she has lost so far. So you should do it. That makes you a Christian. You should do it. Now, verse 7 here said, be sure never to charge anyone falsely with evil. Never sentence an innocent or blameless person to death, for I never declare a guilty person to be innocent. Take no bribe, for a bribe makes you ignorant, something that you clearly see. A bribe makes even a righteous person twist the truth. Yes. The Lord said, as a born-again Christian, if it is your power to help that man, that woman that have come to you for an assistance, you should do it wholeheartedly. He said, you should not take any bribe, because when you take bribe, you will not be able to bring out the truth. He said you should do everything with a clean heart and a clean hands. May the Lord help us in Jesus' name. Now, he said, you must not oppress foreigners. You know what it's like to be a foreigner. For you yourselves, we are once foreigners in the land of Egypt. Yes. The Lord said, anyone that is a foreigner in your country, treat that person very well. Because when you leave your country to another place, you are already a foreigner as well. And those people will not treat you bad. They will also treat you well. So do to others what you want others to do to you. May the Lord help us in Jesus' name. So he said, plant and harvest your crops for 6 years, but let the land be renewed and lay uncultivated during the 7th year. Then let the poor among you harvest whatever grows on its own. Leave the rest for wild animal to eat. The same applies to your vineyard and olive groves. Yes, may the Lord help us in Jesus' name. The Lord said, anything you are doing, that is bringing income to you, bringing money to you, bringing food to you, learn to give to the poor. And if you are the type, for example, you are a farmer, you plant things in your farmyard. He said, anytime you are harvesting, please try to look for the poor people around you. If it is coco yam you harvested on yam or plantain, anything you harvested, any crops you harvested, remember that there is somebody out there that needed this thing as well, just the same way you need it. He said, go to that person, give. And also leave for animal. Leave a little bit for the wild animal. They are the one protecting your farmyard. You don't know. May the Lord help us in Jesus' name. Meaning, in anything you are doing, learn to give. Learn to give. Do not be so selfish. Do not say that you are the only one that needed this thing by all means. The same way you need it, the same way other people need it. But since you are opportune to have this thing, give to the needy. It is when you give to the needy that God bless you much. Not the needy shouldn't be like the people in your household. The needy are people you don't know. You come across them. You are passing this person every day, and this person is in need. And you have that thing that he or she need. One day, visit this person and give. Give wholeheartedly. Pray for this person, and at the end of the day, wait for the reward from God. It is not the person that you help that will reward you, but it is God Almighty that will reward you. As long you do that wholeheartedly, you did not do it for people to see you. You did not do it for people to glorify you. No, you just do it because it is a need for you to do it. You just do it because it is your position for you to do it, no one else. May the Lord help us in Jesus' name. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for your word. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for the word and the understanding. And I pray, whosoever that is in need out there, I pray that may they locate their helper wherever they are, in Jesus' name. Amen. Now, verse 12, Exodus 23, verse 12 says, You have 6 days each week for your ordinary work. But on the seventh day, you must stop working. This gives your horse and your donkey a chance to rest. It also allowed your slaves and the foreigners living among you to be refreshed. Pay close attention to all my instructions. You must not call on the name of any other gods. Do not even speak their names. May the Lord help us in Jesus' name. You know, it's unfortunate that the world we are living right now, people just think that they are the only one that brings suffering to this world. You know, they don't have time to rest. The Lord has given us 6 days for ordinary work. He said one day should be a day of rest. You know, a day for you to pray, a day for you to rejoice, a day that everything around your household shouldn't to work. Your slave, your servant, even the animal you have in your house, they need to rest that same day. But how come that most of us will go to work on the seventh day instead of us to be rested? I don't know, you know. So I don't know if you are the type that goes to work on the seventh day, you have worked 6 days and 1 day off for you to give to yourself and give to the Lord, you know, to thank God Almighty, you know, for protecting you all this week. You still want to use that day for your own self. I pray that as you have heard this word from me, you have heard it from the voice of God, you should repent. You should repent. And I pray that God